I'm Brian Ratzlaff, USPTA Elite Professional and Tennis Director here at the Fawn Lake Tennis Center. I'd like to welcome you to this edition of Tennis Tips. Today I'd like to talk a little bit about the use of our iSmash ball machine. When we take a look at the machine itself, first thing we want to talk about is safety. Please do not walk in front, or some people will look inside to see if there's a ball coming. Assume the machine is on and do not walk in front or look into the machine. As we get into the actual operation of the machine itself, you'll find your on-off switch right here, and then we'll come back to the control panel. There's a remote you can use. If you use the remote, you need to push the toggle switch to this position, or you can just use bypass if you're gonna have two people using it. Otherwise, you're gonna have to run it back and forth. So use the remote to minimize the amount of balls you need to pick up. If you look at the panel here, you can see we have a variety of settings. We can do pre-selected directional patterns where this particular one, just push the button, it'll shoot straight ahead. If you engage this button, it'll go left to right in a narrow pattern, or we go over here, it'll go left to right in a wider pattern. Looking down again at the control panel, you'll see random or directional. If you choose to put the ball in a narrow pattern, it's gonna hit left, right, left, right, left, right. If it's in directional, you can also set it for random. It'll do the same two locations, but it might do two to the left, one to the right, three to the left, so forth. It's strictly a random panel. When we come over to this, here's the height adjustment. The lower your gauge, the lower the net clearance. So if you were to lob, you'd want to set this up to very high. And remembering, if you have a lot of net clearance and a high speed, the ball's going to go over the fence. So as you engage the height to a higher position, you need to turn the speed down. Okay, the scale goes from 1 to 10. So this is how fast the ball actually shoots out. 1 would be barely dribbling over the net. Coming over here to a 9, that would be a bullet. You can also adjust the spin. Turning it down to the left will give you back or underspin. A neutral position straight up will give you a flatter ball. And then if you want top spin, again, this is a dipping ball that comes over the net and dips down, you turn it all the way over here. So again, if you're hitting with topspin, you would need to also make the net clearance a little bit higher, otherwise they'll all pull down into the net. The feed rate, you'll see here on this dial, is how much time between shots. Okay, so the frequency or how often the ball comes out is engaged here. So a 1 would be one ball every few seconds, all the way up to a 9, which might be 2 balls per second. So you can gauge the spin, the height, the speed, and how often the balls come out. For more information on ball machine use, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or check out our webpage, fawnlakecc.com.